Well, impact will Bolton's trip to Moscow have? I put that question to Richard Weitz. He's a senior fellow at the Hudson Institute and director of its Center for Political Military Analysis.
So what President Trump said is pretty much the line he's adhered to in the past several years. So aspirations for nuclear reductions, nuclear disarmament, but a sense that at least for the last 2 years, the U.S. has been lagging behind other countries. So he needs to first arm and then to disarm. So basically give other countries an incentive to do so. My readout from the Bolton visit is primarily coming so far from the Russian press. And there was some criticism over the U.S. decision, but he got to meet with Foreign Minister Lavrov, President Putin. So it doesn't appear to have been a showstopper.
If there is no treaty, I mean, does this lead to a nuclear free-for-all in the world? And he mentioned China. What does it mean for them?
Sure. I'm generally supportive of arms control, but this treaty in itself hasn't been. It was very important at the time it was signed 30 years ago, but now at this point it's not particularly useful for several reasons. Technology's evolved, so at the time Soviet Union and the United States were the only countries that had missiles in the prohibited 500 to 5,500 kilometer range. Now there are dozens of countries, including China, which has about 1,000, at least 1,000 of these missiles aimed at Taiwan and Japan. Bolton in particular has been saying is we need to basically move away from this bipolar model and try and bring in more countries. And that's been very much in line with the Russian thinking. So I think they've reached harmony in that at least.
So following up on that, could that mean a completely new and different treaty? They mentioned no negotiation.
Right. So what? So this treaty goes away, and that means that both, if this occurs, and both Russia and the United States can develop missiles in that range. But they already have these systems launched by air and sea, and they have a bunch of other longer-range systems. So I'm not anticipating a major change. So what will happen is possibly they're going to have to at some point have to revise their larger, much more important New START type treaty, which governs their long-range systems. And one possibility is you would just lower the threshold, so you would basically cover this range, but that each country could decide if they have a common ceiling of how many missiles they have, how many they want to have in the intermediate range, how many in the long range. So still be control, it just give them each a little more flexibility. But again, it looks like they want to include China and a few other countries.
Another big headline, probably not too surprising, this Trump-Putin meeting in Paris next month in November, with other opportunities for these two leaders to have some face time with the G20 summit coming up as well as the APEC summit. What do you think we should look for in those meetings and possible accomplishments, if any, with all of the things going on in the world?
Right. We've had several of these kind of meetings on the sidelines of major conferences, the G20 in Vietnam and earlier in Germany. They've also had now a bilateral meeting in Helsinki. At each of the meetings, there's discussions about common interests, some disagreements, but the actual concrete results have been very few, and I think that's primarily because President Trump just his flexibility is very limited, as the Russians understand, both domestically and internationally. So domestically, Congress has been pretty insistent denying the president authority if he wanted to remove sanctions. And internationally, when he talked, for example, about bringing Russia back into the G8, there were objections from the other partners. So I'm not anticipating there will be much dialogue. The one area where we might see progress in addition to Korea and Iran, some of the regional ones, is of course this, what if we let the INF treaty expire, how do we perhaps encompass that in some kind of new arms control framework? And there the president has more flexibility than in other areas.